My name is Alex, and I'm a counselor at Simpson College Counseling Services. Back in March, when we were all at home, Counseling Services began a video series entitled Be Well at Home. Because this break is such a long one, we thought it would be a good idea to bring this back and release 1 to 2-ish videos about how you can continue to take care of yourself while at home for the next 7 weeks. Today, I'm going to spend a little time talking about change, expectations, and communication. The main thing I'd like to say is to expect change. It's as simple and not as simple as that. The semester was different and going home is also different. Prepare yourself for change as this is the first winter break we've had like this and the longest. Remember to remain flexible in your planning of how you want to spend winter break, but also in your thought patterns and thinking too. Make sure to discuss expectations and set boundaries in advance. Talk with your family about what you are comfortable with, what you're not comfortable with. Let them know what they can expect of you while you're at home, but also let them talk about their own expectations of you when you're at home. And I'm talking COVID-19 related expectations, but also regular expectations too. Will it be an expectation to stay home unless absolutely necessary? Will it be an expectation to spend all your time together with your parents or not so much? Is it expected you will help around the house? You know, different expectations can often lead to conflict, so find those things out and talk about it effectively. We can effectively communicate by finding the right timing, so making sure we're both parties are in a good position and a good headspace to have a productive conversation. You know, conversations aren't going to go well if we're both angry or heightened or upset. Be prepared. Know what you're going to say or what you'd like to get across in the conversation as well. Write it down if you have to and refer back to it during the conversation. Use I statements. So I statements are really great and really cheesy, but they work. So I statements are, I feel blank when you blank, right? So a couple examples could be, I feel uncomfortable when you do not wear a mask at the grocery store, or I feel left out when you eat dinner without me. These are great because they put the focus on you and make it a lot less accusatory and judgy towards the other person. Last thing I'd like to mention is to avoid comparison. So I'm talking about what other people are doing over winter break, but I'm also talking about what you've done in years past too. This is not a typical year. This is completely different and brand new. We are all adjusting to this, and it's important to focus on what's important to you, right? So looking at things that are important to you and how can you make that happen, or what can you do to make that happen for you and your time at home. So give yourself grace and flexibility throughout figuring that out as well. So let's recap. That was a lot in a short period of time. So talk to your family and loved ones about expectations of self, expectations of others, and boundaries you are going to put in place to keep you and your family safe by using I statements and effective communication. Avoid comparisons and give yourself and others some much needed grace throughout this really weird time. Thanks for tuning in. I hope you all have a wonderful break and you'll let us know if you'll need us. So Simpson College Counseling Services can be reached at counseling.services@simpson.edu or 515-961-1332. Thank you so very much and be well.